What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Hermitcraft Amplified server. I hope that you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really... I broke my bass again. Thumbs up for the broken bass. I hope that you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. And today is the day before Thanksgiving, which for the majority of you may mean absolutely nothing, because it is a pretty much a Merkin holiday, I do believe. So if you're not from Merka, or whatever, it isn't a big deal. But you know what is a big deal? Being thankful for the things that, you know, for things. Being thankful for breaking your base. No, but being thankful for things. You know, it's important to, like, to be thankful, I think. I have so much to be thankful for. This year has been really, really amazing so far, and there's a little bit of it left, but I'm confident that, you know, everything's going to continue to be pretty amazing. And I just have a lot to be thankful for, and the majority of the you know, I have a really great house that me and my wife bought last year. We have the channel now, and the things that have been going on with it have been really crazy cool. Just absolutely blows my mind, and... you know, in addition to that, we got married this year, so that's a thing. You know what I mean? There's just been so many things that I can be thankful for. And one of the things we were talking about in the last episode is kind of doing the monuments and the stuff and things for the Patreons. And I haven't been able to do that because I've been working on builds. You know what I mean? We've been doing this thing, man. This crown hall, holy crap, oh man. It's quite a thing. So that's been quite a thing that we've been working on. And you know what? I got to figure out... I didn't even think about that. I need a third color. Speaking of colors, I need a third color. But, yeah, so today what I wanted to do is kind of get back to our roots and start working on a new monument for you guys. Oh, man, I hope that didn't go into the hopper. I think it did, though. Yeah, I lost it. Oh, well, somebody will come up here. Probably it'll squirt out andesite, and then it'll be like, why is there a squirt out andesite? Should have squirted out a minecart. What's it? It's broken. Slipgator, thumbs down. So, yeah, anyway, we're talking about the monuments. We talked about a couple things in the last episode. You guys, we talked about voting about the daylight sensors. Now, that's something that I think that the daylight sensors won. I feel like some people, and you know what's really funny about that, is that I thought that my saying that I like the levers better with influence, you guys have your own opinions. I was like, that's cool, man. They're not just like gonna sheep. They're not just gonna puppy dog and be like, yeah, whatever you say, Slip. Yes, we like the levers. Absolutely, Slip. No, you guys are all like, no, Slip. Daylight sensors, oh my god. So most people said that they do the daylight sensor. So I think we're going to change that and see what it looks like. And then I also asked you where we should do the monuments. Some people said around town, but the majority of people said we should do them back here. Now, I think that means this thing's going to get torn down completely. I hate it. It's stupid. And it's a big giant rock. It's in the way. But down inside of here, this is a really great spot. There's all these cool little outcroppings and things where we could do that. And it'd be a good place, a little bit out of the way, to show thanks to you guys. So I thought today what we would do is honor somebody that has kind of gone above and beyond and donated to Patreon in a way that he's basically the number one. He's the number one donator. And we're going to do a monument right here. We're also going to eventually, I think in the next couple of days, I might do it off camera, rebuild the other Double Amazeballs monuments. And I think right here, well, I don't know. It might look a little, with some balls here and some balls here. It might look a little phallic. I don't know if that's what we should do. I think we'll do it anyway. It'll be cool. But I think we're going to do it up here. So I got some materials and thinking what I want to do. I want to use the andesite, and I'm thinking of using blocks of gold for this. I think it'll be really rad. And we need another block in addition to this. And it would be great if there was another, like, type of yellow. That's really what would be a good color for us. Maybe we could do sand. Yeah, we can't, because it will fall. That won't work at all, man. You're silly, Slip. So we got to get another block of some sort. I'm not sure which. But I'm going to start getting set up. And, well, I'll be honest with you. I think that it's time for a speedy up bit, peeps. We'll be right back. there you have it, peeps. The first triple maze balls monument. And you can't even see it. It's so maze balls. So it's really the perspective I got. Like, I don't know. I thought that was further away. So I was like, it'll be like that high. Like, you'll be able to see the whole thing from right there, right? But no, because you know how I do. I don't like to do things small. So we didn't go small. We went humongous. Look at that thing, man. Triple maze ball. So cool. If you guys like the montage, make sure you let me know. Hit the thumbs up button. This thing's going to look cool at night, too. And another reason why I got to take this down. That's going to take forever to manually mine. Oh, my God. So I think it's pretty rad. We're going to go over and put a sign on it, too. And I did a couple little thingies. Let me see here. Nah, you can't really tell. So I tried to do an optical illusion. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Seriously, go. No, I'm dead. Oh, my God. I can't believe I just died. Oh, no. I respawned. Oh, because I just moved my bed. Oh, no. Oh, my God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Foods. We got to go. We got to go. Oh, my God. I can't believe we died. And now we have to go all the way back. That was... Oh. So completely by accident. Which way is it? Oh my God. Which way is it to get back? I don't remember. And there's no friggin' signs anywhere. I have no idea which way you should go to get back. I'm assuming this way, because there's packed ice over here. So we're gonna head back over in this way. So we might as well just hang out and chit chat. Hopefully the sign here, right here, it says Hermiton Hills. Is there a sign that says that? Hermit Hills, right here. Not Hermiton Hills, but Hermit Hills. All right, let's squirt back here. We should have enough food. Maybe. Maybe not. Oh, it's not that far at all. Holy crap, it's way closer than I thought. All right, we're already here. Yay, we're back. So, yeah, triple maze ball supporter, and the sign. We got to put a sign up on there. But, yeah, so we're getting closer. Thanksgiving's tomorrow, and I want to tell you guys a little bit about our Thanksgiving traditions for my family, for the Gator family, Mr. and Mrs. Gator. And we've actually only spent 3 or 4 Thanksgivings together. And so I've talked about it a little bit before, and I think I say that every time I talk about this, but me and my wife are like super foodie people. Like, we love food, all types of food, strange food, exotic food, good food, buttered food, anything that is food related. We really do a lot of that, and we do a lot of like cooking and stuff like that too, and she's a really good cook. And so she really kind of does this like super awesome spread for our Thanksgiving thing. So do like sweet potatoes, regular potatoes, and we'll have a couple different types of vegetables. This year I'm going to cook. I have a special garlic and carrots recipe that I make. That's really good. And I'm going to make that. We need to grab signs. I don't think I had that on me. Also, look at this. Somebody put a sea lantern here. And thought I would not notice it. I absolutely noticed it straight away, and it looks great. It makes me want a huge amount more. I want 400 more sea lanterns. So that's... It's so cool. I don't know who did it. I'm thinking it might have been XB, because I think I saw him in our Skype chat talking about that he was looking for... where's all my crap? That he was looking for a found an ocean monument or something. I don't know. Somebody squirted that over there. Who knows, though? I'll have to check out some Beeps videos and see... Did I get all my stuff back? That is the question. What da da da? A-pick, a-shovel, a-axe, a-bow, a-sword. And we have our this and our emergency bucket of water and this. And I think that is everything. I feel like we're doing great. All right, so it is night. Let's go ahead and squirt a bed down here and just make it day real quick. Rest in peace, Split, says Toppy. So, all right, and then we don't need these guys. So this thing is crazy big. I think I'm going to take that island out too. But look at that thing. It's so crazy. I didn't think it was going to be that big. But that's just how we do. So it actually is quite a little trek to get up to this area, and I didn't make like any sort of like faster way or anything like that. I'm not going to do like a minecart elevator to get up to it or anything. It's just something that you have to climb up to go and see. But we will put a little sign on it, of course. So the wife will cook. We always do a duck because turkeys are really humongous. And so, like, you like we don't want to have, you know what I mean, even a small turkey, which actually are kind of hard to find, would feed us forever and ever. So we do a duck because, yeah, we're a little Asian-y like that. Because, yeah, I've said it before, just in case you didn't know, my wife is Asian. And so we'll do a duck and roast the duck. And, all right, we have to do the sign right here. So it's for the guy's name's Death to Chameleon. Am I going to spell it right? Chameleon, yeah. Triple amazeballs. Amazeball, I can't fit it all in. And we'll put a Slippy Heart in there. So this is the monument for Death to Chameleon. Thank you so very much for your contribution to the Patreon. And as I like to always point out, I want to thank everybody for everything they do. It doesn't matter if it's from Patreon, if it's from, you know, whatever. If you're liking, favoring, doing stuff and things, any kind of stuff, support that you do, I appreciate it. But yeah, so this one's for Death to Chameleon. So let's head up to the top here and see. Now, the thing that I tried to do, I wanted to try to do something a little bit different, and so I just decided what I would do is offset, so you can climb up to the top here. We're going to have to put some sort of maybe torches, or I need a couple more redstone lamps, but what can you see? You can see the hairy olive from here. That's what I think I'm going to start calling TFC's base. Somebody mentioned that in the comment section, and I laughed and laughed, the hairy olive over there. So, but there isn't a lot of other things to see from up here. It's just kind of crazy, right? There's that cool mountain that I really like that's over there. But yeah, so, and then the insides I kind of alternated. So these are the yellow stained clay and then gold and then yellow stained clay. And then in the center, I went gold, yellow stained clay and gold. And then what I did is you can see right here, this ball is offset one block forward. So I wanted to kind of make it, just try to see. I never tried anything like this before when I was building, but I thought maybe I would do like, it would be like an optical illusion where it looks like the middle is bigger. Without actually having to build it different. And so I thought, well, I'll just offset it one higher. Can I, is there a where, a place, is there a where? Is there a where I could show you this? I'm trying to see if there's a place I could show you this. God, I wish I had ender pearls. And it's probably not going to be anywhere that we can see it. So let's head down over here and check it out. See if you can see it from over in this area. So see, there you can see it's one block forward. So this one's, it actually looks like these two are a level, but they're not. This one's back and that one's back and that one's one block forward. So I thought it would look kind of neat. I didn't want, because I didn't think you'd actually ever really view it from the side, so it wouldn't matter. And then if you see it like this, it actually kind of looks cool. But yeah, so it goes like that. It's a little bit of a curve. It just adds a little something to it. Just experimenting, playing with different building styles. Because I still am not doing anything in creative. I'm doing everything just right in survival. So I try it out here, and that's how we learn and we get better. But I think it didn't really make a difference. I don't think it did. Either way, it does add a little bit of texture to the build. And I kind of like it. You know, not everything always has to be 100%. It's not that it's not symmetrical. Oh my God, everyone's coming. Oh my God, slip. Facepalm. Oh my God, not symmetrical. But it doesn't matter. It's not that it's not symmetrical. It is symmetrical. It is intentional that it's offset. Ooh, almost got in the lava. Ooh, so close. So yeah, that means that that thing is project out of the way. Now I still have three other double Amaze Balls monuments to make. And they are for, oh my gosh, I can't remember everybody's names right now. For Martin, for Dan, and, oh man, I wish I could remember the other person's name right now. I just can't remember it, I'm sorry. And for another double Amazeball, super cool person. Now, those are rebuilds, except for Martin's isn't. So Martin, I'm going to be doing another montage here in a few episodes for. And then the other guys, I'm just going to build them. Now, also, there's a bunch of other signs that we have to put up too. And I'm going to figure out how that's going to work. I don't know where we're going to do the signs, and I still haven't quite figured that out yet. So I have some ladders here right now. And I thought maybe we would climb over here. This is really weird. I can't imagine that this is natural. That this naturally made this weird little bridge. But it seems that it did. So we're going to climb up here. And let's just pillar up and see what we can see. And, oh, there's a little bit of vertigo there, man. A little bit freaked out. I'm interested to see what we can find at the top here. Squirt up there, ladder. Thanks, buddy. But, yeah, that's kind of going to be our spread. And then I'm going to probably bake back to the, we're going to switch back to the food discussion. I'm probably going to make some pumpkin cookies. I'm like addicted to pumpkin cookies right now. And I was talking to Zuljan about it. He's like, pumpkin cookies. He's like, what are you talking? He doesn't like pumpkin cookies, I guess. Or I don't know if I can't remember now if he said he never had them or if he was like not, he doesn't like pumpkin flavored stuff. I love pumpkin cookies and like pumpkin flavored. Oh my God. Pumpkin pie is so good. Cause I'm a pie guy, man. The cake is a lie. I'm all about the pie. Look at that thing. It's way bigger than I thought it would be. That's for you, Death Duke Chameleon. So, but we're going to end up having to take this all down, which is going to be a crazy, I don't know even if, I mean, how long could it take to do? It's going to be a huge thing. It's like another montage probably. I guess I'm probably going to start working on this. It needs to get done. So I guess I'll start working on it now. We're just going to tear this down, and then we can just talk a little bit more. So that was kind of the rundown of the foodie-type stuff that we're going to have. And so other than that, we'll probably do some talk to my folks, too. And it was just my parents' anniversary. They've been married for 41 years, which is kind of crazy. 41 years that they've been together. And most of my other parents, almost everybody else that I have that I'm friends with and stuff like that, majority, I would say like 80%, their folks are divorced. You know, they split up. And that happens quite a bit. So it always makes me see, it always feels a little bit, I was like kind of a little bit more blown away by the fact that my folks have been together for so long. Because it feels like that's quite an achievement these days to have that happen. But something else that I thought would be really cool if you guys would do, one of the things that, you know, when you start, you get a little bit older, when you're young, man, nothing matters. The only thing that matters is video games, and that's it. And so, yeah, that's it. One of the things that I think a lot of people start doing, they do it on Facebook and stuff like that, is they talk about what they're thankful for. And so at the beginning of the episode, I talked a little bit about that I was thankful for, you know, so many things. And I really am unbelievably thankful for like this great gift that I've been given that I'm able to kind of do this YouTube thing. And it's turned out to be, way different than I thought. And it's definitely, a lot of work, a lot more work, I think, than people think. It's kind of crazy. It can be, I think in certain instances, depending on the channel, when you're talking about specifically Minecraft, I think it depends on the channel. Some people put less work in than others, but the way that me and most of the hermits all do it, it's really a lot of work. And so that's been great because I don't mind it. Like I like doing it. It's really a fun thing to do as far as, you know, it's like fun work. But it is a lot of time and stuff like that. And now I've lost my train of thought where I was going, but so I think we're talking about being thankful. So yeah, it's turned out to be a lot more work than I thought, but that's fine. And that's good. Keeps me busy, keeps my mind occupied. But, I really am super, super thankful that I'm able to do this, and it's a great gift that you guys have given me. And so that's why I want to do these things and do, like, you know, special things for people, special things for you guys, because these montages, although for one person, for Death to Chameleon's Triple Amazeballs montage and monument, it really is just a testament to everybody's support, because I wouldn't be able to do any of it without, you know what I mean? It takes a village, man. It's not one person that allows this to happen. So that's just a very, very long and a heartfelt thank you. I'm getting a little teary. A little thank you to you guys. But the other thing I thought would be really cool is that, on this channel, I really like positivity. Like, I'm really all about being positive. Yes, I'm looking at my damage. Yes, I know it's red. So you guys didn't think I was going to know. You thought my pick would break and I wouldn't even know. So yeah, I'm all about positivity, man, because I feel like that, like, being positive is like, if you, like, encounter something that's positive in your life, it, like, charges up your positivity batteries, you know? And it makes you, like, happier and more positive. And then that, like, bounces off some other person who's peeved off, and it makes them happy. And you know what I mean? And then it's cumulative. It's, like, the domino effect of positivity-ness-itude. And So that's why I like to try to be really positive. And I get really, I get kind of bummed when people are like, you know, negative, or especially in this community, because it's so great. We have so much fun. And there's really just no need of it. So, but yeah, we don't want to be negative. We want to be positive. And so today what I thought would be cool is if in the comments section, we really try to grow some of that positive energy and talk about what you're thankful for. And I know that's kind of cheesy, like talking about what you're thankful for. I'm thankful for this or whatever. But, you know, really try to take a second and put something real. Oh, crap. No, get out. Oh, I want to see this at night. Oh, it looks good. Oh, it looks so cool. And the little trail's pretty rad, too. Little trail going up if someone wanted to go up there. Maybe I'll put some gravel or something. Because we're going to put another monument here. And I don't know. They're so big. We got to take that thing down too. But that does look really cool. All right, let's sleep. And we'll talk more about it. All right, so the positivity thing. Down in the comments, just put something that you're thankful for. And not like a cheesy, like a, or whatever. It doesn't matter. You know, I'm not going to judge you. You put whatever you'd like. And, you know, if you see something that you agree with or you see something that you think is really cool, you know, put a thumbs up on it. Let's try to get the comment section to be like a real comment section. You know, a lot of times people, you comment and then you just kind of bounce. You know, we can have great discussions in the comment section. And then especially with the new rating of the way you can rate comments, if somebody writes something really great and then you guys thumbing it up down there, it kind of rises to the top. So it's kind of the only way. It makes the comments kind of more of a community thing if you guys are reading them as well as writing them. So take a second and do that, and yeah, read some other people's too, and try to say something nice to somebody or something like that. Let's just, you know, it's a time for thanking and positivity-ness, and let's do that in the comments. So, all right, I'm going to go ahead and work on this a little bit more, and I'll be our bees, peeps. And we're back, and wow, guys. Tearing this thing down, I didn't know. I was like, it's probably pretty big. It's probably going to take, like, quite a while. It's going to take a long time. Long time. So I've taken 3, like, inventories full of blocks down already. And I've torn it down quite a bit, but this is where we're at. So we're at about a third of the triple maze balls monument. So we have about another third to go. So I got a halfway done-ish, maybe a little bit less. But yeah, so that's the thing. But so I was just going ahead and watching, and one of the things I want to let you guys know about, if you haven't checked it out yet, I've been playing Creativerse. I keep calling Creativerse and Creativecraft, but it's not. It's actually called Creativerse. I've been playing that game quite a bit, and a bunch of people checked out the pilot of the series that I did. You guys should definitely check it out. It is really a really, really great game. It's a voxel sandbox, so it's a lot like Minecraft, which is great, because I know you guys love, I mean, obviously you're into the Minecraft stuff and things, but it's definitely really, really cool, and I'm having a really good time playing it. I can't wait. I'm actually sad because it's in the alpha stages, and anytime you play an alpha, they're always light on content because it's an alpha. Like, they got the engine done, they got the textures done, you know, but it's not quite 100% there yet. So I'm a little bit sad because I think that eventually I'm going to run out of, you know, things to kind of craft and stuff like that. But I don't see that happening anytime soon. Like, it looks like for an alpha, it has quite a bit of content, which is really rad. It's really, really cool and fun. So I hope you guys check that out too. But I got to tell you guys, it has been a really long day today. Building these monuments and doing the montages takes a lot of time. So make sure if you like it that you let me know and you hit the thumbs up button. That's going to be it for today, guys. I hope that you guys have a great Thanksgiving. Make sure you leave a comment about what you're thankful for. And if you like the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit. Don't spam it on Reddit, peeps. And I hope that you guys have a great rest of your day. I can't see in front of me. Oh, I'm scared. No!